Chiplets and advanced packaging have been on the cutting edge of electronic technology for a while now, but Intel is changing where that might be headed. In particular, today's substrates like ABF are going to be getting some competition by a common material, glass. Intel has been showing off their facility for building glass substrate chips. Intel has been working on this process for over a decade, but it will be a little longer before production chips are made on glass. Still, the process is being refined and the advantages of glass are apparent to chip developers. Large high-end system-on-package designs will be the initial target for glass substrate solutions because of the ability to link together large and numerous chiplets onto a single platform. Glass has some great thermal characteristics and it can be extremely flat, for example. And it's going to be ideal for chiplet applications. So, Jim, why are chiplets going to be important?
Oh, we've had a problem with Moore's law scaling for the past over a decade now, where because of lithography equipment's limits, it's incapable of making a die size larger than a certain size, and so that's called the reticle limit, and that's kept people from putting more transistors on chips. It's led people to say, oh, Moore's law scaling is dead. But Gordon Moore actually spoke about the possibility that chiplets would be used in the future. So it's not a surprise. Now people are finally starting to embrace that technology. It's being used widely in AMD processors. Intel is following suit. And it looks like it's going to be used in a lot of other places. It has been used in FPGAs. I think Xilinx started using it before anybody did. So it's a very now well-understood technology. And you would expect to see it just grow from here.
Well, from that standpoint, one of the substrates that's being used is ABF. What about the availability and any limitations that may have?
Chip companies have had a couple of squeezes put on them. You know, the ABF problem was difficult maybe a year ago. It was probably between summer of 2022 and all the way through the beginning of this year. Now we've got, you know, problems with CoWoS availability, the CMOS on wafer on silicon. That's gotten in the way of NVIDIA being able to ship their product. So, you know, a couple of shortages, and that's made people focus an awful lot of attention on substrates and how do they get away from being constrained in what the substrates are. And there's a lot of experimentation going on there.
Well, obviously, Intel's been working on glass substrates for almost a decade now, but they're now actually talking about it and indicating that it might actually be coming to fruition in the next couple of years. Yeah. How is that going to impact the companies out there?
It's good because glass is a very inexpensive material. And I know that theirs isn't going to be inexpensive. They're probably using something highly precise that you know, that fits with the whole world of semiconductors. This is a whole industry that just is based on tight tolerances and very expensive things. But in the long run, it will be a viable competitor to these other materials, particularly silicon, because raw silicon as a substrate is a pretty expensive thing to, you know, add another wafer onto the cost of existing CMOS. And so because of that, they're driving some of the costs up, but they're also setting themselves up to be able to create enormous substrates. I don't know how far that's going to go. I saw a press photo from Intel that looked like they had a substrate that was probably about five, you know, half a meter wide and half a meter tall. And, you know, I could picture, just based on what's going on with LCD TVs, that substrates could be made as big as the substrates that they use for those. I'd hate to see something as complicated as the system that would be built on a substrate the size of an LCD panel, but you know, it certainly could happen.
Well, I'll look forward to see what happens in a couple of years. Thanks for giving your insights, Jim.
Oh, it's an exciting time in the industry. Thanks for inviting me to speak.